Hi, I'm Dr. Cary Goldstein. I'm the founder of the Goldstein Dental Center here in Atlanta, Georgia. When it comes to working in the posterior part of the mouth, I like the short shank burrs from my occlusal preparations or anywhere that I'm trying to do a crown preparation, etc. It just gives me a little bit more space, even when I've got a very small head on my handpiece. When you take a look at tooth number 19 here, we're going to cut an occlusal preparation. I like to use a pear-shaped diamond when I have virgin enamel to work with or decayed enamel to work with. Need to make sure that you move into all of the grooves and don't leave any brown discoloration. We particularly like to use a cavity detector, whatever brand that you prefer, to make sure that you put a dye inside the tooth, make sure that all the decay has been removed before you go to restore your tooth. These restorations can be very shallow. If they're deeper restorations and you're close to the pulp, I always line my restorations with a glass ionomer, a flowable glass ionomer to protect the pulpal surface before we etch. So we clean the surface, place our liner of glass ionomer, and then we etch and bond our tooth. That way, we find that we have almost no sensitivity in the final restorations.